King is coming, my Lord, your God. King is coming with the glory of God. Yeah, I believe. King is coming. Glorious. My Lord, to conquer this world, defeat the devil, our enemy. I want to share the word of God. It is revealing. At this time, we see every day what's going on in this world. The sign that has happened in this world, Jesus prophesied at the Mount Olivet about the end of the world. So I want to share the word of God just predicted the sign of this world, Matthew 24, 21 to 22. Listen, my brother and sister. Today's text, that is very significant word that we have to focus on this word of these days. For then there will be the great distress uncalled from the beginning of the world until now, and never to be called again. If those days had not been cut short, no one would survive. But for the sake of the elect, those days will be shortened. Yeah, this word is about the last days that are going to happen, and comforted for the Christian, the holding this world. Yeah, what you said, those tribulations will be shortened for the children of the God. Oh, hallelujah. It is a pivotal New Testament prophecy. Pivotal New Testament prophecy. It reveals to you about what is happening now than any other chapters in the Bible. Yeah, you can realize that this prophecy, this praise we have shared with God just before, it's talking the sign that is happening now, as Jesus Christ predicted. This sign has happened exactly what Jesus Christ foretold. Jesus was sitting on the mountain, Olivet, the very place where the prophet Zechariah had predicted that Messiah would stand when he came to establish his kingdom. Zechariah 14:4. It was a fitting place for disciples to ask Jesus. They asked, what then shall these signs will be. What signs will going to happen coming over you and the end of this age? You know, it Matthew 24, it the most important prophecy that Jesus Christ proclaimed at his first coming. Also, as you know, Mark 13, Luke 21 have their version of this prophecy. I believe Matthew had the most complete prophecy of the last days. You know, when the disciple asked Jesus, tell us, what shall this happen? What shall be the sign of thy coming and the end of the world? Jesus responded, listen what he said. We have to focus on Jesus' reply of this question. It is very, very important. Jesus Christ interpreted the seven seals of revelation. Seven seals of revelation. Revelation chapter 6 through the 8. It is good to understand to you about Jesus Christ's answer that disciples have asked to him, what's going on in this world and the time. Keep listening. The first four of these seals are often referred to as the four horsemen of the apocalypse. It is explained in Revelation chapter 6. In this chapter, Christ prophesied about the volcanic eruption. Volcanic eruption that going to happen the last days. And the crisis on this earth. We've been seeing by our eyes every day. Yes. Crisis. The chaos that has been happening everywhere in this world. Such alike. natural disaster that has happened in America, Florida, Texas, you know, last year. Fire in the mountain, earthquakes, and everywhere in this world. We are seeing now, as Jesus Christ had predicted exactly, it is happening now. That's why I'm talking to you now. What Jesus Christ had said, the sign of end age. All those are happening that such as has never been experienced. And about the birth of the new age that will come from it. The seven seals in Revelation formed the story flow of the book of Revelation. You know what Revelation reveals, the end of the world. Here is the overview I want to tell you. A little bit. The first seal reveals first prophet. The second about the war. Third about the famine. The fourth pestilence. Fifth heavenly signs. Sixth seal is a tribulation that I'm going to focus on these six seals today. You can see. And the seventh seal, seventh trumpet. Oh, that Jesus will come. All right. If you understand these seals in Revelation, they lead you step by step the return of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Oh. Are you still with me? He returns at the last of those seven trumpet blasts that, you know, seven angels are holding the trumpet and starting shout, blowing the sound that the wrath of the God pour out this earth by bowl judgment of the bowl, you know. All right. I want to tell you that what I'm saying to you, I'm going to approach the theme of today's message that is concerning of Matthew 24 chapter 21, 22, we had shared. It is about nuclear weapon, nuclear bomb, or so the second coming conclusion, these seven seas. Yeah. I believe you agree with what I'm saying. That makes this prophecy. Yes, I believe. I'm believing. The Book of Revelation that is showing a lot of sign of this ending world that Apostle Paul had seen the vision and the revelation of the God in the island of Bamo. Even though it contains a lot of bad news, we see in the chapter, the whole chapter, until chapter 18, yeah. 19 chapter is the glorious page by Jesus Christ who will come this earth with the saints. You know, chapter 18 of Revelation, in the God to rest, pour out this earth. We see a lot of bad, worst in the Jews we see in through the chapter 6 to 18. All right, but I will say, listen, my brother, sister, the most wonderful news we are waiting to receive and to hear, the victorious news, Jesus Christ will come with the King. Yeah. He's the King of Kings, Lord of Lords. He is conqueror to defeat the devil's power in this world. Hallelujah. Oh, give him glory. Oh, the Lamb of God will come. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. The most wonderful news imaginable. We are eagerly desired to hear the Jesus Christ, the second coming, hallelujah, praise the Lord. Everything revolves around this prophecy. It reveals more to you. Yeah, much, much. This revelation of God, that the Apostle John has seen, and his insight of revelation he revealed in through the Book of Revelation, we see now. It's about you, about the Christian. You have to learn and be comforted to understand the last days, the situation, and eagerly desire to waiting for Jesus Christ. And about what is happening now, than any other chapter in this Bible, I believe. All right, I want to move. The topic, the last day, is concerning the Mass 24. Let me give you the prime example. Listen. North Korea. I'm South Korea. Yeah. My mother country is South Korea. North Korea is, as you know, evil empire now. I can't believe that. What's going on in this country? Oh. North Korea is the spotlight of all the news media now. Every time I see the North Korean news through the TV, it's a front page news around the world. There is a massive region. Why? I want to explain it. As you know, North Korea has threatened in the America as well as South Korea and all of the countries by the nuclear weapon. They never give up to use this nuclear weapon they're going to attack other countries. They fire the missile. They test an atomic bomb 26 times during a decade. You know. Let me tell you. I go to back to Bible. After the four horsemen of the apocalypse comes, then we see the sixth seal. I'm talking to you. It is a great tribulation. We are now at the age of the nuclear abyss North Korea is doing now. North Korea has those missiles that can apparently reach any American city. You know, all the leader of North Korea, Kim Jong-un, the rocket man, Trump said, he's a crazy guy, madman, has to do, push the button, and a billion people will die. This is just one example of what the sixth seal is all about, or the great tribulation is all about. North Korea, as you know, is bizarre in the extreme. North Korea region is bizarre in the extreme. A hermit kingdom. Hermit kingdom, you know. Run by wild, utterly ruthless and highly erotic God. He is a king. He's a people. Just a God. Not king. He's just a God. People follow and worship the Kim Jong-un as a God. I can't believe that. They're all crazy. The regime is a savage. And culture-like. That country is not nation. The nation is a cult of religion. It's their people, robotic. Robot. What they are doing? As read, as commanded. They are doing now. Oh my Lord God. You know, soon this madman could have 100 nuclear bomb and a missile to destroy all the mainland of this country. This is reality. Huh? You know? This is not fantastic. This is not fantastic. This is a real story we are facing now. I'll tell you more. It gets even worse. Kim Jong-un shares his nuclear, that's a big problem, power with Iran. Iran, Middle East. The number one terrorist sponsoring nation in the very bizarre in the extreme in the world. Weird. Utterly ruthless. Vicious reader in Iran. And highly erotic king, like a god. Same thing in the North Korea. Listen, he believes the Kim Jong-un, a crazy guy. He believes that he's going to destroy all over the world by this nuclear weapon, and the leader of Iran believes that a nuclear catastrophe would even hasten the coming of the Messiah to rule the world. Their Messiah, we call the Magi. They're like our Lord Jesus Christ. They believe the Magi will come. They are waiting to rule all over the world, Islam world, by force, not by peace. That's why terrorists is arise and killing every people in the world. That is a satanic counterfeit of the sixth seal or the great tribulation. I want you to read Revelation 6 chapter 12 about the sixth sees. Second coming of Jesus Christ. These two men, let me tell you, yeah, these two men, yeah, about concerning the second coming Jesus Christ, North Korea and Iran, the crazy leader, have changed the nuclear equation, this world we are seeing now. You know, many nations have weapons of mass destruction, including nuclear bomb. Prophet Daniel called this the time of the end or the Christ at the cross. All right, I don't have much time to preaching now. This is part A, the summer. And following the part B, I'll preach next week. I want to tell you just this word, and this summer will be closed. Christ has wonders repeatedly of the worst time of suffering in human history. He asked many times, be prepared, you don't know what time the Son of Man will come. You do not expect. Be prepared. Pray. And watch. Watch that we have to listen to what Jesus Christ warned us. Next week's sermon will be continue about North Korea and what's going on in this world concerning of the Bible that revealed us through the Book of Revelation. You will not miss what I'm going to do and what I'm preaching the next week. Hallelujah. Pray the Lord. I can't wait next week. Bye-bye. See you later. Amen.